is 8. We're here at 7. And it is absolutely rammed already. It's 7:15. Apparently, the gates have opened, but the queue is slowly shuffling forward, so we might be able to get in a bit quicker.
Get into Super Mario World, we need to get a entry access ticket, so that's why we're here so early. You have to do it in the park, and everything is saying if you get here when the park opens, you're not getting a ticket in there.
Okay, so we made it inside. There is a bag check which slowed everything down, and if you do come and you're queuing, go over to the far right
as you can.
Yeah, because it looks like it kind of like opens up as you go in, and there's a lot more space to the right. So they were moving people over. So the people who were in the right got to go in sooner. So do that. Also, if you're trying to get into Super Nintendo World and you haven't booked in advance like we have.
So by booking in advance, he means kind of like getting an express pass that allows you entry. Because if you have an express pass, you can just like, it's just a fast pass. You can go in, you don't need to book a time.
If you don't do that, you need to book on the app, like a timed entry slot. But there's a really bad error message because you have to register your tickets to say that you have tickets to the park or studio passes. And then on the app, you have to go in and say you want to get entry. But the app doesn't tell you why you're not able to do it. It just says there's a problem with your tickets or this pass can't be used. So we were worried that we had the wrong type of ticket or it was sold out or something. But literally, as soon as we scanned our tickets to get into the park, I just hit refresh on the app and it worked. So if you are wondering why you can't get in, as soon as you go through the turnstile, you can book your entry. So we got half 12 till half 1.
Yeah.
And now the stress is gone.
Oh, literally. I feel bad. I get very stressed. I was so stressed. And
very angry, actually.
Honestly, that queuing system, because today is sold out, I think, and that queuing system was just like insane. It took us like 45 minutes to get into the park from when it said it opened. We got in at about ten to eight, maybe, and we got a ticket for 12:30 to 1:30. So definitely get here before park opens if you're doing it the way we did it.
Now to go find something to queue for to get on a ride, because I'll be honest, I've done barely any research on this park before coming here. I think Gemma's done more research, but we didn't come up with a ride route. So I think the plan is get in one of the long queues for a big ride now,
yeah,
and plan what we want to do with the rest of our time.
Well, we kind of know. So we know today is going to be super busy. I've been keeping an eye on wait times for the week, and it is really, really busy, like 2-hour queues. So we've got 4 rides that we really want to do, which is the 2 in Super Mario World, the Harry Potter ride, and if we can, the Jaws ride, because that's no longer in Orlando. So if we can do those 4, that would be great. Anything extra is a bonus. I will say as well that when I looked up about early entry, the park opens an hour before, and from what I read, the you can go in, but there's no rides open. But I don't know if it's just because it's a really busy day today. The rides do seem open. There are people on the big rides. So you might get lucky if you get here early that you might be able to get on some rides.
Where Dumbledore falls out. R.I.P. my boy.
We jumped in the queue for the Harry Potter ride. It's saying 100 minutes. It's only 8:30, so we're like, why not? It's not feeling like a 100 minute queue. It's going quite fast. So we're gonna do that, and then we're gonna look around the shops in Harry Potter World, maybe ride Flight of the Hippogriff, and then...
Who knows?
We'll look at the wait times and decide.
Yeah, because we need to be ready for 12:30 to get into Super Mario now.
Yeah. We've got an hour slot.
Yeah. But it's good to get in there straight away, I think. Okay, so we got to leave our bags in the lockers. So it looks like we'll put the camera away and we'll see you after the ride. So Gemma, what do you think of the first ride of the day?
I done it before. What do you think about it?
What do I think? Well, first of all, it's really cool. It's kind of like a Super Mario. It's kind of like a Harry Potter All-Stars. It felt like there was like little bits of all the films and stuff there. So if you're really into the movies, there's a lot of like callbacks and cute little Easter eggs and stuff to see, like the big scary face the basilisk comes out of is in one bit. There's like dementors and stuff. It's really, really cool. And the theming in there is insane. Secondly, we got an e-stop, which is pretty exciting. The ride stopped while we were on it. We were in front of one of the screens though, so when it restarted, the screen didn't restart. So we got a kind of like sickening wobbly bit in front of a big grey screen. It was really disorientating and really strange. But because we had the e-stop, we got let down a special queue when we got off and we were allowed to ride again. So we got to experience it twice, which was really cool. Which meant the second time, I spent most of it trying to figure out how the ride works. Because you're in front of these screens for absolutely ages. And I was like, there's no way that the other cars don't just back up, because it's continuous motion. It loads, like the cars don't stop. It's like a water ride. So I was like, what's going on? And then I noticed that the screens actually move. They like enclose the cars in and then it all moves as one piece. So that is really, really cool. I imagine it's terrifying if you're inside the show building and watching, because there's so many moving parts. There's a lot of like screens, and there's also a lot of animatronics happening all at the same time. And there's like hot air being blown at you, there's like water. Oh, it's absolutely great. Really, really recommend it. And our queue was only like 45 minutes.
Yeah, so the queue time was posted at 100 minutes.
Yeah.
And we waited, we got in the queue, I think about 20 past 8, and we were out by 9.
That's really, really good.
Yeah. So happy with that.
Really good. So unfortunately, there are only two rides in the Harry Potter, the Wizarding World here.
They don't have Diagon Alley here.
And we're skipping out on Flight of the Hippogriff, which is the other one. And there is a queue for the wand shop as well, which is currently an hour, Ollivander's. But that's not really on our list of things to do. So we're now queuing for a butterbeer, because it's absolutely rammed and we have to queue to get drinks.
And Kyle's never had one before, so he has to try one.
I've never had one in a park. I have one in a random pub in Edinburgh.
Oh no, that was not that way. That wouldn't count.
Which gem are getting a photo?
So we went for the frozen butterbeer. This is the one I think I had in Florida, and it was better than the one that's not frozen. So we tried this one. Kyle is doing the taste test.
The cream is like weirdly thick. That's so sweet.
It's sweet.
That's like a butterscotch.
Yeah.
Slushy.
Yeah. Do you like it?
It is good. It's very sweet. A lot sweeter.
That's why I said one.
Yeah, that's fair. That's fair. And it was 850 yen.
Yeah.
So that's...
what, 1,000 is £5?
Yeah. So it's like £4-ish, yeah. I guess. So here's our dilemma. The park is really busy, obviously, as we keep saying. And we've got to be at Super Mario Land between 12:30 and 1:30. Obviously, don't want to miss that. So trying to find a ride that's got an appropriate wait time is a bit of a challenge. We're thinking about the Flying Dinosaur. It's 130 minutes and it's currently 10:05. So if it takes 2 hours 20 minutes, we'll be done at 12:30, which is our Mario time. So we'll be able to walk over there and get in. But if the queue runs over or the time's wrong, we are running the risk of missing it. What do you think, Gemma?
I think we do it.
Yeah?
Just because 2 hours it takes us to 12:05. If it runs over by like 30 minutes, yeah, we won't be able to get a snack, but we can always get a snack inside and just pay a bit more.
Yeah. That's it. Again with the lockers. Must be a universal thing. At least it fills me with some hope that everything's okay when you get to walk down quite a lot of the ride queue without having to stop. That's quite nice. Yay! Doesn't mean we can't natter to the camera in the queue, so... Oh no, we got a while. Ah.
Wow, that ride was so good. We ended up, so the queue time is posted at 130 minutes, as we said before. And we actually only ended up waiting about 90. And the queue wasn't so bad, it was like constantly moving. And what's good about the lockers here is the lockers are like 90% of the way through the queue. So once you get to the lockers, you know you're nearly done waiting. And oh my god, that ride was so good, wasn't it?
It was amazing. Sorry, I didn't realize you were putting it in.
And I don't think we realized when we got in the queue, but it's a ride where like you're on your front, so you sit down and it like lifts you up and you're on your front, and the lift was the longest lift ever. You could see so far into the distance.
Yeah.
And then doing like multiple inversions and loop-de-loops whilst on your front was just like such a different sensation than any other roller coaster I'd been on.
Yeah. And, like, cool. There was a massive loop right near the end as well where you were turned upside down on your back.
Yeah.
And it was just a really weird sensation.
But also like the drop, because like the drop was really steep and it genuinely feels like you're going down head first. Yeah. On the, oh my gosh, that's crazy. Right, so we've got 45 minutes until we can go into Mario World. So we're gonna get a quick bite to eat because we're both feeling quite hungry and Carl's feeling a little bit sick. So we're gonna have a sit down, get something to eat, and then off to Super Mario World. I think as well, just to get a picture of how busy it is today, this is a snack cart. The line goes all the way around the corner. Like, it's crazy. Also, that's what we just rode. It is time. This is the queue. So everyone here has a reservation to get into this area of the park. We just like queues in Universal Studios. So we're queuing. We didn't manage to get a like food before we went in because the queues for everything were just insane. So our plan is to, once we're in, is just head straight for the quick service, wait in a massive line, and then sit down for a bit and eat. Because we're like, once we're in, like, it'll be fine. So we're nearly up, nearly in. Cool. Okay, that was a relatively quick queue to get in. Now we are walking up the road. Oh, here are the power bands. They're like $30, so about £25, I would say. Maybe £20. We're gonna do a little bit of research before buying one. We might not buy one because it is expensive. I don't know why I film. Let me film me.
Beautiful footage of the park.
There you go. So we're not sure about the power bands just yet. We're gonna do a little bit of research whilst I sit down. Just because of the price, they are a bit expensive, but Carl is determining whether he wants to have that added benefit of going around and doing the power band adventures. So if you don't know, the power bands are like Disney magic bands. So they're a little bit more, they're a bit more interactive. You use them and like find different spots and scan them, and you can like, I don't know, Carl, what can you do? Get points?
Yeah, so you link it with the app and you can get points to like go into like a secret area, and there's like a leaderboard. But mostly there's like bits of decoration that you can touch and it animates them.
But here is a box, and you connect your power band to it, and it like lights up and it gives you like points or whatever Carl said. Okay, so we were going to go into the cafe, but there's a sign outside that says you need a ticket for the cafe, or the next pickup time is 3 o'clock, and the next time you can sit down at the cafe is 4 o'clock. It is now 1:30. That is not happening. So we have decided to wait in this queue for Yoshi Snack Island and just go with whatever that they're serving, because we're really hungry at this point. Carl needs some food to feel a little bit better. So we're just eating whatever we can. I will say that that's been a bit of a tough thing for today. Just like how much, like how difficult it's been to like get food, because it's at capacity. I would say, I think it's at capacity today. The queues are insane. Like, we queued, what, 20 minutes for a bus of beer this morning at like 10 in the morning, and now like just everywhere's got insane queues for food. It's kind of hard, isn't it, Kyle?
Yeah, I think it's just managing expectations, I guess. It's cool when you get a theme park day where it's totally empty and you can go on absolutely everything, but trying to just enjoy it It's been a while since we've been in a theme park that's been totally rammed.
I was saying in the food side is the hardest part today.
Oh yeah, the food side sucks.
I don't mind queuing for, like, we knew it was going to be long wait, so I don't mind queuing long for the rides. That's just how it is. But the food situation is hard.
Yeah, it's kind of depressing when you're like, oh, really hungry, I need something to eat now. And the world's like, okay, you need to wait 2 hours.
Yeah, we got in a queue for a pork cutlet sandwich, and we're like, okay, it's 800 yen, that's not too bad, we'll just get it, whatever. And then we got to like three or four people before we got to the front, and she came up and was like, sorry, the sandwich is sold out, and there was nothing else, they did no other food. So that was really,
really
yeah. But that's just our little what to expect if you're going on a busy day here. Okay, we've got our goods. We got a green shell yakisoba calzone with yakitori with cheese calzone. So, can you show me? Oh,
it's sealed like all the way around. I thought it was open, like a.
It's more like a bao bun.
Yeah,
I would say.
But it's like pizza crust.
Oh,
it's really hot as well.
Do you want to try it for the camera? Are you feeling up to it? I can try it if you want me to.
Let me give it a go. Let me get this in here. It looks pretty good. It's heavy as well.
It is quite dense. Yeah.
Can you see me okay?
Yeah, I can see you. Can I look inside? Focus, please. Interesting. What's it taste like?
I was expecting a bao bun, but it's definitely a calzone.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Is it quite cheesy?
Not super. The flavor's not super intense. The bread is really nice. Like, it's really nice and like doughy and like light.
Okay.
I actually quite rate it.
Yeah. Good.
It doesn't taste like green food coloring.
We finished our lunch and I didn't really enjoy it. It was yakisoba, by the way.
Yeah, my bad.
It was noodles, cheese, in pizza crust.
Yeah.
Not my favourite thing. Kyle, what did you like it?
I quite liked it, but I'm a fan of like mildly cheesy, bready, bland food.
Yeah, that's like, what it was.
Stodgy noodles, because it was like quite stodgy, because the cheese with the noodles, so.
Did it help you feel a bit better?
I do feel better. I feel reminded, like, maybe I was just hungry. It's quite substantial as well.
It was enough for a meal, I think.
Yeah.
Well, I could have done like a little side or something as well, but now we've come to the Mario Kart Koopa's Challenge. I don't really know anything about this ride. I only knew Yoshi's Adventure, so this is gonna be fun. The queue was 2 hours. It's dropped down to 80 minutes. So we thought, whilst the car's feeling a bit better, let's hop in it whilst it's a bit shorter.
Yeah. The queue theming is insane.
Yeah, the queue in here. I will stop talking and we will show you what this looks like.
I really like the Queen Bee on the DS one. I think it was Mario Kart 7.
I didn't play the 6DS.
Obscure character. Either that or Dry Boat. Yeah, classic.
My favourite is Toad.
Toad?
Yeah.
Is that because you are Toad in real life? What are the noisy things?
On the subject of Toad, outside we saw Toad. And I was like, Carl, look, it's Toad. And Carl went, no, that's a statue. And then Toad moved and Carl got scared.
It was very scary. It was like a weeping angel from Doctor Who.
Hello. It's about half an hour later. The ride has broken down. So we all sat on the floor for a bit, waiting for it to hopefully pick back up. But no dice. The queue is being cleared. We are leaving, but we are getting an express pass, so we're hoping, our plan is like, we're just going to hang around in the Super Mario World, maybe go to the shop, maybe do Yoshi's Adventure, and then hopefully this ride will be back open and we can use our express pass for there. Yoshi's Adventure jumped up to 2 hours, so we've come into the shop. I'm not sure this is going to be a pleasant experience, but we'll try and film it.
Wow.
Yep.
Oh. Not gonna lie. Is this recording?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
He's pretty good.
Yeah, I love
him. You want it?
I think it'll be good for the plane to sleep.
Yeah, I could see that.
It's 4,600 yen, so that's like 25, 30 pounds, so probably not.
Maybe not worth that.
It's great. The term the Super Mario World Shuffle, because to walk anywhere in Super Mario World, you got to walk like this.
Happy birthday!
See how I'm not going anywhere? The Shuffle, Super Mario World Shuffle. I recently got a sweater vest, but I should have held out. Look at this!
Yeah, could have got a bucket hat.
Oh my god, we could have both gotten sweater vests and been Mario Luigi. Okay, we survived. We're back out in the wild. It's really busy. Oh, look, it's Toad!
We've reached a bit of an impasse. Well, we can't leave Super Mario World because if we do, we can't get back in because you need a ticket to actually get into this part of the park. But because the Mario Kart ride is down, everyone's gone to the Yoshi ride. So the queue for that has gone up to like 3 hours. And if we do that, that's potentially all we have time for. We have an express pass we can use. But 3 hours is probably a bit too long. So then we kind of have to wait and either gamble on the Mario Kart ride opening again so we can use our express passes, or just call it and leave Mario Land, which would be a bit of a shame because we haven't done either of the rides. So we're currently musing over that. What are you thinking, Jenna?
I'm thinking we found a place to sit now. A bit loud, I don't know if you can hear. But we found somewhere to sit. So I think we stay seated and we just like chill for a bit. And then if like in half an hour, 40 minutes, if it hasn't opened, then we call it.
Yeah, I think he's going out. Getting paid off, it's been about half an hour. And it looks like the ride is back. So we're going to jump on the Mario Kart ride, use our express passes.
Yay, we don't have to wait 2 hours.
So, we did the Mario Kart ride.
Yes.
But Gemma, what do you think?
I hate to say it, but I was a bit disappointed. The reason why, I think the technology is super cool. So basically, you're doing Mario Kart, but you're wearing a visor. And in the visor is all the other contestants. And you've got to like hit them with the shells. And you get points based on who you hit. But the visor, you can't see much of what's going on. And there's so much happening. And your range of vision is so small. It's really difficult to understand like who you're meant to hit, who's coming up, where you're going. And the thing is, like, you're steering, but like the car's gonna go that way anyway because it's on a track, so I don't think there's any like point. I did find the rainbow road section. I was like, when it happened, I was like, ah, it's rainbow road! So that was a good like nostalgia trip. But it wasn't, I would have been really upset if we'd queued 2 hours and I felt like that disappointed. Kyle, what did you think of it?
Yeah, I think Gemma kind of hit the nail on the head. It feels, so I might say something a bit controversial here. Super Mario World is really, really cool, but it's kind of all style and not a lot of substance. There's only two rides and one of them is a kids ride. The other one is a Level Up Band experience. And there's so many people in there and the land is so small that it's kind of hard to like enjoy it that much. Like we queued for like an hour for food across like the popcorn and the main meal. Maybe we're just here on a busy day, but most days are like this. So this kind of is the experience. And I think the ride, like it's super high tech. It's super cool, but it's just like there's a lot of little problems. Like the visor's field of view is really small. So you're trying to...
And it's really heavy on your head.
Oh, it's really heavy. So you got that. It's kind of like a VR headset type way. And like, I kind of thought the other riders that you were throwing the shells at would be on the track, but they kind of just fly in from everywhere. So it's a real like just, it's very busy. There's a lot going on. And it may be, I don't know, maybe it would be better if it was toned down a little bit, because it just comes across as a little bit confusing.
Yeah.
Which is a shame, because the theming in there as well is amazing. But you can't really appreciate it, because there's so much stuff in the overlay going on.
This is how, like, I agree with you quite completely. This is how I feel. Like, I think that the theming and the technology in that part of the park makes me so excited for theme parks in the future, because the creativity and, like, just the immersion and, yeah, it's just amazing. But I think there is a few things that are a bit of a miss for me in there.
It feels a bit bad. I don't want to say that, like, it's overhyped.
It's not overhyped, because when you go in there, it's really breathtaking. And, like, it's definitely worth seeing. It's just, like, I think as well, like Carl said, we came on a, it's so busy, like you are just shuffling, like you can't walk. It's just a bit too small. So like, I think it's a combination of things. Like, we came on a busy day, it's quite small, and there isn't that much to do if you don't buy the power band.
No. So yeah, definitely. Well, it's kind of tough, because like, I want to say factor in the cost of the level up bands and do that. But then,
but it's
I get so busy that getting to like the things to do is pretty hard. Like, you just end up queuing to like punch a block.
Yeah, it's true. It's true.
If you were kids, though, I mean, if you're a super massive Mario fan, like obviously do it. You'll have a great time. And like, if you've got children, obviously do it with them. They'll have a great time. But I think for mid 20 somethings traveling around, it's probably not the 10 out of 10 experience that I was kind of hoping for.
Yes, I agree. I think I've said everything that I need to say. I think it's worth, if you're coming to Osaka and you want to do a theme park day, definitely come. You won't be disappointed. Just know that there are some like kinks, and like you will be queuing for like ages for everything. Okay.
And bring some food. Honestly.
Yeah, don't keep
even
food.
If you're like us and you want to eat park snacks, bring some food with you, because
just like, even as it's like just in case, because if you have a day as busy as this, you're queuing like half an hour, 45 minutes to get, like, we queue for I think about half an hour to get our little calzone.
Yeah.
And that's like that and the popcorn and the butterbeer is like what we've eaten today, because we can't even get into the restaurants.
Yeah, and when we do, they're sold out.
Yeah, so
yeah.
But bring food with you. I feel like we're moaning a lot. I don't want this to come across as moaning. Like, I am, but like, we're having a good time. It's just there's a, I just wish it was a bit.
Yeah, just temper your expectations,
yeah.
I guess.
Yeah.
So as you can now see, it's dark. Kind of a bit early for us, but we have actually stepped out of the park. Because of the wait times, if we were to jump on something at like 5 o'clock, we wouldn't be getting out until 7:30 and we'd be absolutely starving. So because we're kind of tired, and because we've done the things that we wanted to do, so while we have cut our day a little bit short, we figured it'd be good to use the extra time to go check out City Walk outside the park and try and find something a bit decadent for dinner. I think we're currently looking at Hard Rock Cafe, because you know
what the menu is.
We're in Japan, so where else do you eat besides Hard Rock Cafe?
I feel like you have to do at least one Hard Rock Cafe on a trip like this. There's so many of them, but I can't see the menu, so I can't see any prices.
That's gonna be the next problem. Let's see if we can find it inside.
Hard Rock Cafe. We were just like, we could do Shake Shack or like something a bit cheaper, but we both just want to like have something a bit decadent and just like a burger and end our theme park day with something like Hard Rock.
Universal Studios is all like American properties anyway, right? So it kind of fits.
I just want to say, I feel like we've come across in this video a bit like moany about, or like, but we haven't had a good day. And we definitely have had a good day. Universal Studios and a theme park day is always a fun day. We loved the flying dinosaur. I was really excited to like bring Carl to see the Harry Potter world, and it's like so nice seeing it, because it's like it's exactly like the one in Orlando. So Super Mario World, whilst we have like some reservations about it, was good. We've had a really, really good day. We're very grateful that we had this day. We love theme parks. I think just for us, by the end, we were like very, very up for like queuing and like we knew it was gonna be busy today, but by the end, like our queue fatigue did get us, so that's why we didn't do that last ride. Hello, we were rubbish and didn't actually film our dinner. We kind of got in there, sat down, and went into like zombie mode. We just like scrolled our phones, didn't really talk to each other. We're very tired. So we finished dinner, and it's time for us to go home and go to bed. We've been up since 5:30. It is 7:30. It's not even that late. It's 7:30. We're knackered. We've had a great day, like I said. The queues have been a bit tough, but you know what? We've had a really, really nice day. We love a theme park day, don't we, Kyle?
Yes. We are big fans of theme parks. Hence why we're here.
Hence why we're here. So thank you for watching the video. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and do all that fun stuff. And we will see you in the next video. Good night.